Hey everybody, doing pretty okay tonight, so we got another set rolling out. By the way, I'd like to remind everybody, in the description below there are links to Brando's Patreon. He's making a game, and there's actually a, he threw together a little video of his, promo video of his progress so far, and that's gonna be down there as well.
We won't be defeated!
I just gotta try to remember what the fuck I'm doing. So, another news. Is that an enemy? That is a slug thingy. Bloodsucker doesn't like wind.
Oh, holy fountain! But they can still suck our blood, right?
Good question. They sure can, especially those in the front.
Everyone okay? But yeah, in other news, was it February XCOM 2's coming out? What was that? The Enemy Unknown came out in what? 2012? 12 or 13, so. And I guess there's a mod called Long War that got made for it, and the devs, like, praised the mod and actually took some inspiration for it for the second one. Saw a few videos of, preview videos of it so far, and it looks pretty damn awesome. And yes, I know it's not the original XCOM, I know I have a few of the old guard roaming around, and I agree. Nothing will ever beat the days that fat-ass fucking Parker saved the goddamn Earth from the aliens. God, that was my 500th video special, because back then it was like, 500 videos, I can't believe I'm still doing this shit. And now it's like, 3,500 plus videos later, and it's like, oh yeah. But yeah, there is a, I do have an, XCOM and, UFO defense let's play. It's way down in the fucking list though, because that was literally thousands of videos ago. It's also my first time actually ever beating XCOM. First time I ever went to Cydonia. Come here, you little fucking... Okay. There we go, we got to see Nicolio's super attack.
Do
your urbanization form's not that bad. It's just he hasn't gotten his, you know, he hadn't gotten his fucking kill everything drugs. You know, his fucking mystic art yet.
Let's make it quick. Oh, holy water. Yeah. Feel our words.
Okay, stop. obnoxious little fucker? Yeah, I was thinking, since I didn't get, what is it, Enemy Within, the expansion, until it was actually on sale for really cheap this year, I think maybe I'll do
it. Nice to be able to put my hair up with a barrette, right?
What's a barrette?
That was a difficult battle.
I think maybe I might do a playthrough of Enemy Within. I'm actually trying the Long War mod out right now, and holy fucking balls. It's like, you get a lot of people, you get a lot of resources, there's a whole host of... I might do the Long War one.
Here you go.
Get my health back. It's like, yeah, here, have a few hundred of this resource for killing a few of these types of enemies. I can see why the FAQ for it said start on normal, though. Because it also said to ignore the first large UFO that lands in the second month. I understand why they would tell people to do that. It's like a fucking supply ship in the second month you have no chance of shooting down. And it's about, 12 chrysalids tough. And roving packs of four. Thin men aren't pussies anymore. But then again, that's what lots and lots of explosives are for.
Here.
Guinevere Tower Ruins. North is Genglen Ruins. Or Falling Rocks and Landslides. Carelessness can lead to injury or... Genglen Ruins.
Let's do this!
Yeah, that's just kind of what I've been doing when I've been feeling that under the weather recently. So, is that? No, it doesn't have a big thingy, so it's not a freaking crucible of bullshit. Hi. Those things are annoying as shit.
I mean, I used to be pretty okay at making food, but now? Really? Let's restore our health.
Ready, Nicleo?
Ready,
Nicleo? Pack them a level in. Resilient aim. Sorcerer. Oh, holy fountain.
Oh, I fucking hate that move.
Ready? Don't shake. Give it a second.
Quite a fearsome fighting style.
Is that a monolith?
Humans use martial arts and hidden arts, Seraphim use martial arts and seraphic arts, and when armatized you use hidden arts and seraphic arts. Which arts you use should, of course, take into account whether the enemy is weaker in defense or art defense, but you should also familiarize yourself with what type of attacks they use. Understanding this will help you truly dominate your foes. Or just use the good old strategy of group up and hit it till it dies. Due to prior incidents, no unauthorized entry is allowed. Robbers will be punished severely. I'm not a tomb robber. I'm an archaeologist. Yeah. It belongs in whatever museum can pay me the most for it. Oh. Spiky Thulu!
Keep your guard up!
Ice.
Be careful of October's jump attack! Isn't that kind of like the month of October? Good point! Let me explain it to you. Maybe later. Like, a lot later.
Speaking of archaeology and whatnot. Oh crap. Right, there's a fire over here. I wonder if that's significant anyway. But
is anyone ready?
Come for it! Yeah! Water! He's on!
Damn monsters! Let me get a fucking word in edgewise! What are you guys even weak against? Use anything except earth and water.
You were quite strong, but we're no pushovers either.
Yes, we have Sheena Inu Girl and Bunny Woman. Fear us. But, yeah, so Thursday we're finally gonna get the ball rolling on the 5th edition D&D thing. That's gonna be interesting. I think I already went over what kind of a crazy bastard I'm gonna be playing. I'm essentially Crimson come from? Ugh, can't speak right now. I just woke up. Leave me alone. I'm basically the cryptic bullshit machine. I'm a crazy old hermit. Babe, human monk. Leaves everything's connected to the universe. That's the backstory we're old. But I hide my secrets. I don't share my secrets with anybody. So, you know, yeah. Everything's connected to the universe. And I'm not really going to tell you why. Just, I'm literally the cryptic bullshit generator. I'm probably going to wind up being the crazy, emaciated old hermit in a dirty loincloth leading our party around. From the sound of things. So, I guess DM's giving everybody a unique variant on one of their skills, so I, instead of medicine, I basically have herbology kind of shit. So I know all the good plants to make drugs out of. He's already got a little list of recipes and rare herbs and, you know, special herbs and shit he's working on, so I can make drugs. Make drugs and brew wine and all sorts of shit to either help us or get us into fucking trouble. And then, I don't really know. Oh, pretty much what the character's backstory winds up being is, before my hermitage, I came from basically the big temple city kind of place. And the other reason I'm probably going to wind up being the de facto asshole leading people around is, the reason for my hermitage was I found out something that I shouldn't have found out. And I left before other people found out that I found out what I shouldn't have found out. And that's part of the reason I'm a crazy old hermit that lived in the woods on the opposite side of the island. But, and I guess I have a guy chasing me. There's some random asshole named Kaladin chasing me around. Because something happened with the rangers in this forest, and Kaladin thinks I'm responsible. Even though Kaladin's kind of affected by whatever, because Kaladin's been acting weird as well. So fucking knows. And of course there's the old, you start on an island kind of deal, with like, a shallow land bridge being kind of the only way to get anywhere close to the mainland, because all the deep waters are infested with Kraken, so we don't, like, run off away from the campaign. Yeah, it's a bit of bull, you know, it's one of those trying to... I mean, we can go anywhere we want on the island, it's just don't try to run away from the campaign, motherfucker. Because you know how, you know how DMs, they have their carefully laid plans out. Get their carefully laid plans and then, you know, I have this all laid out. You know, there'll be this happen, and then the player, you know, then of course being a player, you're just like, okay, we're gonna do some crazy ass shit and just completely bypass all this, you know, bypass everything. Instead of going through this elaborate side path to evade our enemies and whatnot, we're just gonna, you know, bullshit, muscle, batshit crazy our way through something and reduce the epic encounter to some comedy show, basically. Comedy show of the boss getting their ass totally handed to him. You know how it goes! So yeah, the waters are infested with Krakens. Everything so far has been... There's a hellion back there. Or wait, back here. Huh. Must be a cryptic bullshit button.
Don't overdo it, Rose.
Oh, holy God! Yeah. Heal our wounds!
As far as the rest of the party is concerned, I don't really know a whole lot about them or their specialities or, you know, I just know what they are. So, to help me on the front lines, there is... Can I get over there? But to help me on the front lines, there's a Dragonborn fighter spec to dual wield. So, and if you don't really know much about like the last couple editions of D&D, Dragonborns is not Mr. Fushro Da. It's basically a half dragon, a big old dragon man. So, you know, bonuses like strength and charisma. Big ol' dragon man! He has a breath weapon based on what type of, you know, genealogy, you know, what species of dragon he descends from. Forgot what, I think, I don't know if he said he was a red dragon? I forgot what kind of dragonborn he said he was, or the DM said he was. But basically, big ol' dragon man! He's gonna be like a whirlwind of fucking axes and shit. It's like... Blah, 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 blah. Oh god, I hope he doesn't sound like a murloc when he does that. That would just suck.
It's over.
hey, somebody said, you know, it's like one of those things, like, somebody said, why don't you just talk about life stories or something like that, when there's not, like, a whole lot to... I mean, at this point, there's not really kind of a whole lot to comment on game-wise, except, look, we're going into a derpy ruin to fight more monsters. Now it's time to prattle on about nonsense, like I usually do. Wah-ha-ha-ha-ha. Which I'll do here to continue on in a second. So, I gotta remember where I'm at in my tale. Be right back.